A TikToker inhaled 1 kilogram of whipped cream propellant every day for 6 months. This is what happened to his brain. GG is a 20-year-old man presenting to the emergency room with cognitive impairment and leg weakness. He couldn't stand or walk without help. Gigi was a student at the local college, but he was someone who loved clout. He'd post videos online of him doing crazy things for likes and subs. Gigi lived in the apartments on campus with his friends. They had been roommates for years. One of the guys, Jake, liked to make desserts. He had a whipped cream dispenser that used little cans. They push gas into the cream, creating that airy whipped texture. This nitrous oxide is the perfect gas for this application, but it's also known as laughing gas. It has legitimate medical use, like at the dentist, but it's sometimes used for something else, and the roommates started to notice. Jake would use flavored gas. This made his whipped cream delicious, but those cans were huge. One day, Gigi told the other roommate to hold the phone. It was time to make a video. He took the big can, he held it up to his face, put his mouth on the nozzle, and twisted. Immediately after inhaling the laughing gas, Gigi felt his vision go dark. He tried to speak, but his voice was a totally different pitch. He started laughing, and he just couldn't stop. He tried to grab the wall, but then he lost control of himself, and his body went limp as he collapsed to the floor. Everyone thought it was hilarious. When Gigi was able to get up, he couldn't believe what happened, and this was the start of something horrible. At first, he'd just check it out on the weekends, but quickly, the entire week was the weekend. He was doing it all the time. It became the first thing that he'd do in the morning before getting out of bed. One evening, Gigi felt like he was going to have a panic attack. He cleared almost an entire box of whipped cream chargers. On the floor, almost passed out, he tried to sleep, but he couldn't. He couldn't remember what day it was, and he couldn't remember where he was, but there were no thoughts going through his head. When he tried to get up to use the bathroom, he stumbled. He thought he could feel a weird tingling in his feet, but things were only going to get worse. Gigi got to the point where this was the only thing that he would do all day. His roommates thought it was funny to just see him slouched over on the couch. They would egg him on, but then they started noticing that when he would try to get up, he couldn't stand without holding onto something. They laughed at him, but when they saw him try to walk, he stumbled and smashed his head on the table before falling to the ground. When the roommates saw blood coming from his head, they called for an ambulance, and he's brought to the emergency room, where we are now. At examination, the medical team noticed that Gigi was disoriented. He could speak, but he couldn't tell them where he was or what his name was. Clearly, something's wrong with his brain. If he fell and hit his head, this could be a head injury. The trauma can cause a brain bleed, causing swelling as the brain starts to crush up against the sides of the skull, causing permanent damage. But when they took a closer look, his brain looked normal. There was no bleeding or swelling, meaning that something else was going on. Gigi couldn't stand or walk on his own. Doctors noticed that. When they tested the reflexes in his legs, they find that he didn't have any. Reflexes are bodily responses that don't require input from the brain. The impulse goes through the spinal cord back to the muscle. A missing reflex could mean something's wrong with his nerves, but this wasn't his only problem. Gigi was still confused, and he said nothing that made any sense. When they asked him what this three-sided shape was, he said, hamburger. This cognitive impairment with absent reflexes means that Gigi has problems in both his brain and his spinal cord, but it still isn't finished. Looking at his blood cells under a microscope, they find that his red blood cells are larger than normal. They couldn't really hold on to a lot of oxygen. Doctors didn't know about Gigi's laughing gas misuse. He didn't tell them about it, and he couldn't, because he was so incapacitated. But putting together his problems with his blood, his brain, and his spinal cord give them some clues as to what's happening. Red blood cells are made in the bone marrow. If they're released too early in production, they come out too big, and they can't function normally. But why was this happening to Gigi? Red blood cell precursors are some of the most quickly developing cells in the body. Sometimes a hormone will tell the bone marrow to release developing cells early, but that doesn't seem like it's happening to Gigi. For him, it seems that his red blood cells just aren't developing fast enough and that they're being released unfinished. So this means either a toxin is inside his body disturbing his blood cell production, or he has a nutritional deficiency. And in the case of nitrous oxide misuse, the answer is the toxin causes a nutritional deficiency. The name tells us why it's a problem, starting with nitrous. Air is about 80% nitrogen. It's actually not majority oxygen, so our bodies are used to this mix. Nitrous oxide dissolves in blood at a rate 35 times more than nitrogen, but it doesn't like to stay there. The reason this becomes a problem is that it leaks back out in the body and becomes a gas again in air-containing places like the gut. That's fine because the gut is stretchy, but not all spaces in the body are stretchy. The ears have air, but if you increase the pressure, you'll blow out the eardrums. This means that nitrous oxide can displace oxygen and take up extra space. This will cause users to suffocate. That'll cause permanent brain damage and death, but Gigi isn't dead yet. But it looks like he actually has brain damage now, because after a couple days in the hospital, Gigi can talk, but nothing makes sense. And he can't stand or walk on his own, but he didn't suffocate, so what's wrong? This brings us back to nutritional deficiency and the name nitrous oxide. A lot of times when oxygen-containing chemicals that aren't supposed to be in the body in large amounts are put in the body in large amounts, they can oxidize metals. This inactivates them. Some of these are pretty important functions. Red blood cells contain iron, which carries oxygen. Oxidizing iron makes it so that blood cells can't carry oxygen, but that probably isn't happening here because it would cause Gigi to turn blue and it would show up in his blood test. But one metal that's involved in red blood cell production and the maintenance of myelin, the fatty sheath that covers the nerves and the brain, is cobalt inside of vitamin B12. If Gigi's incessant nitrous oxide use caused the cobalt in vitamin B12 to get oxidized, inactivating it, then this makes sense why he has big and useless red blood cells, why the reflexes in his legs are absent, and why he has cognitive decline. But something's wrong. A blood test finds that he isn't deficient in vitamin B12. His levels are normal, but this doesn't explain what's happening. Vitamin B12 is a coenzyme, meaning that it's a chemical needed by an enzyme to function. Enzymes make new chemicals, and they consume things that ought not build up in the body. If vitamin B12 isn't working anymore, then the enzyme can't function normally anymore, meaning that either no chemicals are made or the wrong chemicals are made. Vitamin B12 coenzymes for two specific enzymes. In the cell nucleus, where the DNA is, methionine synthase is one part of the process that makes DNA. Without vitamin B12, DNA synthesis is impaired. In a cell that's supposed to grow and develop quickly, development isn't normal anymore. So when it's time for them to be released into the body, they're not developed and they don't work like normal, kind of like red blood cells, explaining what's happening. In the mitochondria, powerhouse of the cell, vitamin B12 coenzymes for methylmalonyl coenzyme A mutase, which generates a chemical that's used to make ATP, used as energy by cells. This is why you'll see vitamin B12 supplements saying that they aid in the conversion of food into energy, but the reality is the resulting chemical is a very common one. The body makes it from fats and proteins. The problem is, when methylmalonyl coenzyme A mutase doesn't work anymore, the chemical that's supposed to be consumed builds up in the spinal cord. It replaces a chemical that's used to make the fat in myelin. The right fats aren't made anymore, and the myelin starts to degenerate, causing spinal cord damage, explaining why Gigi was missing reflexes. But it wasn't just the myelin that was affected. The white matter in his brain could also no longer make the right fats, causing degeneration there, ending in cognitive decline. Gigi's vitamin B12 levels in his blood were a little low, but still normal, because the B12 was still in his body. It's just that nitrous oxide had inactivated it. When they ordered another blood test for methylmalonic acid, a chemical that's not supposed to be high if vitamin B12 were present and functioning, they find that the levels were double the upper limit of normal, meaning that Gigi has all the problems as if he had a vitamin B12 deficiency. Not getting enough B12 is more common than you think. Sometimes people just don't eat enough of the nutrients that they need. I had a B12 deficiency once when I was dieting. Animal proteins are a good source of B12, but to lose weight, I ate a lot less proteins than I had had for at least the last 10 years before. My neurologic problem with B12 deficiency wasn't cognitive impairment, at least not that I knew of, but rather it was insomnia. And ironically, I figured out I had this problem when I started drinking energy drinks at nighttime because they contained vitamin B12, and I could weirdly sleep well after consuming a couple of cans. I did order my own blood test for methylmalonic acid, and it was in fact high. For Gigi, if he has inactivated vitamin B12, then the answer would be to give him more vitamin B12. You can't really overdose on it because it dissolves in water and gets excreted in the urine, and he would have to stop misusing nitrous oxide. This misuse has been happening for a long time. Imposing restrictions on it seems really difficult because there's a legitimate culinary use for it. It's even found in off-the-shelf whipped cream cans. There's a legit medical use for it too, as an anesthetic. But the galaxy gas meme that came from 2024 TikTok is a new generation of something old. Sometimes the gas cans are contaminated with other gases, and they can do things like oxidize the iron in your red blood cells. Other times, people will get nitrous from a balloon, and when the gas knocks them out, they choke on the balloon and die. Compressed gases also become really cold when released, so this can cause frostbite and permanent damage to the mouth and throat. But maybe the biggest reason why you wouldn't want to do this, because the permanent brain damage thing doesn't matter as much here, is that it'll shrink your balls and reduce your sperm count. For GG, after several months of abstaining from nitrous oxide and taking his vitamin B12 supplements, he was able to think again a little. He was able to function semi-normally, but he still had trouble standing and walking on his own. His vitamin B12 problem was much more severe than a deficiency because a deficiency happens slowly. The liver has stores of vitamin B12, but taking something that deliberately inactivates B12 will shut down critical parts of the body at a much quicker rate and cause permanent damage, as Gigi was able to kind of make a recovery. Thanks so much for watching. Take care of yourself and be well.